So this video will show you how to delete classes in Quia and add classes in Quia. So first log on to Quia, spelled Quia.com. If you can't remember your username and password, please reach out to me or Michael Marsalia for help on that, and we can help you retrieve your credentials. Once you're logged in, go ahead and click on Classes if you're not there already. Now this screen might be empty for you if this is the first time you've logged in or if you've already deleted your classes from last year. So if you have classes listed here from the previous school year and you'd like for them to go away before you start your new classes just to clean up your screen, next to the class, so I have one class listed here called Biology Period 1-2, you can click on the delete link and then it will just ask you to confirm that you're deleting that class. So I'm going to click delete. And now this is the screen that if you've never logged in, you're probably looking at that says My Classes and there's none there yet. So I'm going to show you how to create a class. Click on Create New Class. You have to name the class. So I'm going to call it, let's call it Chemistry Period 7-8. An end class, an end date for the class, excuse me, and this is just for expiration purposes in Quia. You can always edit this later if you had to. So I'm just going to choose July 1, 2015. Now, for this option, you need to leave it on the instructor enroll selection. There's some information down here that's encouraging student enrollment, but Michael Marsalia and I have already loaded all of the students in the school into Quia. So just keep it instructor enroll because you're actually going to choose your students out of a predetermined list. So go ahead and click submit. Now it's going to ask you to set back and edit later. You don't actually have to add anything on this page, but I'll tell you what some of these options are. So class name and class date you set on the last page. If you want to go ahead and type Park Ridge High School here, you can. If you want to put in Park Ridge's website here, you can as well. This is what you would be addressed on the student pages. For example, Miss Bacolis has assigned you a quiz. So unless you want your first name to appear here, you would type out how you want the students to address you here. You can add a message to the class here if you want, like remember to use your notebooks as you go through these quizzes, or you know, welcome to our class quiz page, or whatever you would like, or you can just leave it blank. If you wanted an image to represent your Quia class within Quia.com, you could. And the rest of this information are things that you'd typically do on your Fusion page, like useful links. So you can just really leave the rest of this blank. So go ahead and click Save Changes. So now you can see under Classes, you have your class listed. So you can go ahead and do that for all of your classes, all of your periods. And now I'm going to show you how to add students to those classes. If you go ahead and click on Roster next to the class that you're trying to edit, okay, you get a list of these cells here. If you have more than 10 students in your class, which is likely, you can click on this button down here that says Add More Rows. So that gives you another 10 slots. And if I click it again, now I have 30 slots. So it's likely that many of you have about 20 or so students in your class. Now, under these fields, if you start typing a last name, like I will start typing M-I-L. Well, I guess there was no M-I-Ls, so M-I-C. As you can see, it populates all of the students in the school with M-I-C in their last name. So when you find the student you want, you can just go ahead and click Enter. And it enters their first and last name, their student ID, and their email address. And then you can just move down your roster to the next student and just choose them out of the list. If you choose one by accident that you didn't mean to, you can click over here on the little X and it'll take that student out of the row. When you're done, you just click Save Changes and you've completed the setup of your class and enrolled your students.